Australia's climate policies are in the international spotlight at COP26. We've been ranked last out of 64 countries in the latest Climate Change Performance Index. That's placed below Kazakhstan, Saudi Arabia and Russia. Here's why. Australia's carbon emissions per capita stands out on the world stage, especially among developed countries. Per capita emissions are calculated by dividing the country's total emissions by the number of people who live in the country. According to the most recent data available, each individual person in Australia emits 16.3 tonnes of CO2 annually, while the global average is 4.72 tonnes per person. This means each Australian's carbon footprint is more than three times the global average. We're the highest emitter per capita among developed countries. Here's how we compare with others. The United States is second among developed countries, with each American contributing 16.1 tonnes of CO2 annually. Qatar in the Middle East is the highest emitter per capita at 38.6 tonnes. The UK has pushed down its emissions over the last 20 years and how each person contributes 5.5 tonnes annually. China is a big polluter, but its huge population pushes its emissions per capita to 7.1 tonnes per year. Countries at the bottom of the ladder for low emissions are mostly African nations. The Central African Republic, Chad, and Somalia all have annual emissions per capita of less than 0.06 tonnes. Scientists say that emissions must be reduced by 45% by 2030 compared to 2010 levels, and that net zero emissions must be reached by 2050 if the world is to have a good chance of remaining within the 1.5 degrees Celsius warming threshold. 190 nations and organisations committed to quitting coal-fueled power at COP26. But Australia did not sign the pledge. So what are our plans to reduce our emissions? Our government says Australia has reduced its total emissions by 20.8% since 2005 and is committed to reducing it by 26 to 28% by 2030. Australia says it has a plan to use technology, such as carbon capture, to reach net zero by 2050 and will invest billions of dollars to reduce emissions. But the Australian government has not promised to walk away from fossil fuels altogether.